Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. I'm Savannah and this is Grits and Gratitude. Today's dinner time video is gonna be a little shorter than the previous ones, and that's just because we had a week of celebration. This week was our 2-year wedding anniversary. It was also my grandmother's 75th birthday. So we went out to eat a little more than we usually do in the typical week. So I only have 4 dinner ideas this week, but hopefully even though it's a shorter video, you guys are able to find some dinner inspiration. So let's get into it.
So on Sunday, we had pulled pork sandwiches. I got this pork tenderloin. Actually, it's a pork loin. I got it at Lidl for $1.50. Sometimes when it's the day of, they will mark stuff down to $1.50. So I scored this almost 8-pound pork loin for $1.50. So I'm just seasoning each side with some onion powder, some garlic powder, and some salt and pepper. And I'm just putting this in the crock pot, and I'm going to put 1 cup of chicken broth. I don't really buy chicken broth, so I have the broth base, and I'm just gonna add some water to it and give it a stir. I cooked this on high for about 5 hours. You could cook it on low for 8 hours, but I didn't start this until after noon, so I just went ahead and put it on high. And in my other crock pot, I am emptying 1 can of just plain baked beans. I think these were actually like the maple and brown sugar one, but I think next time I'm just gonna get the original because I like those a lot better than these. But I am just seasoning them up with some onion powder, garlic powder, some onion flakes, salt and pepper, and then I'm just adding some brown sugar and giving that a stir. And those are just gonna go on low until they're warm. They're already fully cooked, so they just have to go for a little while. And this is the pork loin after it was fully cooked. I'm just gonna scoop off all the fatty pieces and get those out of there so I don't shred them up with the meat. And I'm actually gonna use half of this loin for the recipe tonight, and then I'm gonna use the other half later on. I just shredded it up and froze it, but I'm putting the one that I'm gonna use for the barbecue sandwiches in a bowl, and then the other one I'm just shredding it up, and I'm just gonna set it aside to cool for a little bit. And I will just pop that in the freezer until I know what I'm going to use it for. But here I'm just adding some salt and pepper and some barbecue sauce. I used a little bit of a tomato based and a little bit of a mustard based, but after I got it mixed, it looked like it needed a little more barbecue sauce. So I added some more of the tomato based barbecue sauce and a splash of liquid smoke, and our barbecue was ready. Now I am putting some butter in a pan, and I'm just melting that to toast our buns in for our sandwiches. And when it was time to serve, I just served it up with some of the waffle fries I got at Lidl. I just put those in my air fryer, and then I had some baked beans. My husband doesn't really like baked beans, so I just gave him double the sandwiches. This was a really good meal, really easy, and I don't ever think you can go wrong with a good pulled pork sandwich, so we really enjoyed this dinner. On Monday, we had country fried steak with some mashed potatoes and fried okra. So I am just peeling some potatoes. Some of these potatoes were really small, so they were such a pain to peel. But I got them peeled, and I'm just giving them a rough chop and putting them into this pot. And we're just going to cover the potatoes with water and put them on the stove to boil. And while those are boiling, we're going to go ahead and mix up our biscuit dough. So I don't remember the exact measurements, but I'll put the recipe down below. But I'm just doing some flour and then some sugar. And we're also going to add some baking powder and some salt and some cream of tartar. I've never used cream of tartar in a biscuit recipe, but it worked out pretty good. So I'm just giving the dry ingredients a mix, and now I am shredding up some very cold butter. Now, if you have a pastry cutter, you don't have to do this, but I don't have one, so I just shredded the butter so the butter would be easier to mix into our flour mixture. After we get that shredded up, we're just gonna add it to our flour and give it a toss. And we're gonna get in there with our hands and really kind of combine it until it looks kind of crumbly and mealy. And after it looks like coarse crumbs, we're gonna add in an egg and some milk. And then we're just gonna get in there and mix it up with our hands. It's a really sticky dough, so your hands are gonna get really messy, but it's worth it. And after we get it mixed up, we're gonna dump it out onto a floured surface. I just cleaned off my countertop and put it straight onto the counter. And I'm just gonna work the dough until it kind of comes together. You don't wanna overwork it because you want to still be able to see chunks of butter throughout your dough. So I am just cutting my biscuit dough. I patted it out to be about 1/2 inch thick, and I'm just using a mason jar to cut out my biscuits and place them on a greased 9x13 pan. After we get them arranged on the pan, we're going to brush them with some melted butter, and these are going to go into what I believe was a 425 degree oven. I don't really remember, but I'll leave the recipe linked below so you'll have all the details that you need. Now I am seasoning up some flour and making my egg wash mixture. So I just have all-purpose flour with some garlic powder, onion powder, salt, and pepper. And then I have an egg, some whole milk, and then again, some seasonings, just like salt and pepper. And I am dredging the meat and the flour, dipping it in the egg mixture, and then back into the flour. I'm gonna do that with each piece of meat. The only thing I did to the meat at first was just season it with salt and pepper, and then I went into breading it. And we're gonna add this to a skillet that has some hot oil in there, and we're just gonna let it fry for about 6 minutes or so on each side. I just kind of flip it back and forth until it looks right. And then my biscuits were done, so I took them out of the oven, and I'm just brushing those with some more melted butter, and they are good to go. In the other little saucepan, I just have some vegetable oil that was getting hot, and I just added in some breaded okra, and I'm just gonna fry that until it's golden brown. And now I am just getting my mashed potatoes going. So I drained my potatoes and I just added some butter, some salt and pepper, and I'm just giving those a mash. I put in some heavy cream just because I had some that I needed to use up. And then I also put some milk and I just gave that a mash until it was the consistency that we like. But you can put however much milk until your heart is content. So now I am just checking the temperature of the steaks and they are good to go. So I'm removing those from the heat and I removed a lot of the grease from that pan and I'm just adding in some flour to the drippings to make a roux. Then I'm adding milk little by little. Sorry, the camera angle is weird. I just didn't realize I was putting that jug of milk right in front of my line of view for my camera. But I'm just pretty much making a pan gravy with this. So I'm just adding milk until it's the consistency and the thickness that we like. The only thing I seasoned that gravy with is salt and pepper. And this is what it looked like when it was all good to go. So we have a piece of the steak with some of that gravy, the mashed potatoes and homemade gravy, and then some fried okra and those homemade biscuits. And this was probably our favorite meal of the week. It was the most complicated one. It took me the most time, but it was definitely worth it. On Tuesday, we had some homemade spaghetti and meatballs. So I'm just getting my meatball mixture ready to go. So I have one package of mild Italian sausage and a pack of ground beef. And to that, I'm adding some Italian breadcrumbs, some onion powder, garlic powder, and onion flakes, a little bit of thyme, some parsley, salt, pepper, Parmesan cheese, some milk, and I think I was supposed to add an egg to that, but I didn't, and they turned out fine. So I'm just getting in there and mashing that up until it is completely combined. And then we're going to take the mixture and roll it into about golf ball size balls. And we're just gonna fill that pan up, and these are gonna go into a, I think it was a 350 degree oven. It could have been 400, I don't know, but I'll link the recipe, of course. And they're just gonna bake until they are done. While the meatballs are in the oven, I am just boiling up some regular old spaghetti noodles. And in my saucepan, I am putting a can of prepared pasta sauce, as well as a big can of crushed tomatoes. And I'm gonna doctor that up with some onion powder, garlic powder, Italian seasoning, and some fennel, just a little bit of fennel, you don't want to go too crazy, and a little sprinkling of parsley. And I'm also going to put some pepper and some salt, and I'm just going to give that a mix and just let that simmer for a few minutes until our meatballs are done. After our meatballs come out of the oven, I just check the temperature to make sure that they were fully cooked, and now I am adding them to my sauce, and I'm just gonna give those a stir to get them coated in the sauce, and then we are going to assemble our plates. So I just have my spaghetti with some meatballs and the sauce on top, and I topped it with some shredded mozzarella cheese. Now my husband, of course, he doesn't really like pasta, so I just made him a meatball sub and threw him a piece of garlic bread on there. I did have a piece of garlic bread on mine, but it's just not in the video of my finished plate. But this was dinner. Those meatballs were amazing. I love them. I will make them again. And then on Wednesday, I made some teriyaki chicken thighs with zucchini and rice. So I'm just seasoning up these boneless, skinless chicken thighs with some salt and pepper on both sides. And I'm going to put those in my air fryer for about 10 minutes. And then I'm going to flip them over and go another 10 minutes. While those are in the air fryer, I am just going to chop up two zucchini. We really like zucchini. It's probably one of our favorite vegetables to eat. So I'm just going to make a big batch of zucchini, and whatever's left over, we will take for lunches. But I'm just giving these a rough chop, and I'm going to get out a skillet, and in that skillet, I'm going to put some olive oil and some garlic, and we're just going to saute that until it starts browning up just a hair. And after it sautés for just a couple of minutes, we're going to add in our zucchini. Once we add our zucchini to the pan, we're just going to season it up with the usual salt, pepper, onion powder, garlic powder, and we're just going to let that cook until it starts to get a little bit of color on it. You can cook it however long. I mean, some people like really tender vegetables and some people like them firm. We tend to like ours kind of somewhere in the middle. I don't like them to completely disintegrate, but I don't like them crunchy either. And there I was just adding a little bit of soy sauce and some honey just to try to make a homemade teriyaki sauce, but that wasn't working, so I just went in with some actual teriyaki sauce and gave it a stir, and it was good to go. And I also brushed that same teriyaki sauce on our chicken thighs. So this is what it looked like when it was done. We just have the rice on the bottom topped with the zucchini and then our teriyaki chicken thighs. This was really good and it really hit the spot if you're kind of craving some oriental food. But that is all I have for you this week. I really hope you enjoyed this video, even though it's shorter than they usually are. But hopefully you got some dinner inspiration. If so, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Bye guys.